वाइस चेयरमैन ऑफ द नीति आयोग डॉक्टर राजीव कुमार, अदर डिस्टिंग्विश्ड मेंबर्स, द सेक्रेटरी श्री अमिताभ कांत, अदर्स फ्रॉम द नीति आयोग फ्रेटर्निटी एंड फ्रेंड्स. It was about time that the agenda for India for the years and decades to come also is laid down. At least we know what the targets are. And obviously there was no better organization other than the Niti Aayog which could have done this job, for the reason that one of the functions of the Niti Aayog now also is to act as a think tank. And with the kind of human resource the Aayog has, they obviously have the intellectual facility also to think ahead. That's a facility which persons belonging to different academic streams who constitute the Niti Aayog, who can reflect on the realities of India and then realize as to where we really need to move. I think when we determine the strategy for New India, we also look at where we stand today. We stand at a very important era in Indian history where we can make up for a large number of lost opportunities of the past. Now, whether it was the fact that we were under a foreign rule in one generation, and then we came into an era of regulated economy, and thereafter we liberated ourselves and came into an area where slowly we started opening up and allowed human energies and human resource being unleashed in India, entrepreneurship being unleashed in India. And unquestionably our experience has been that a society which doesn't grow will never have the adequate resources itself in order to service the poor and get millions out of poverty and give them a good quality of life. And therefore, when we passed through an era where we had slow growth rates, bulk of our planning was regulated around the fact that either the state has an opportunity and we would supplement the rest with slogans. Slogans were never backed up with either resources or they were never backed up with any significant or material change that took place on the ground. But today I think situation appears to be different. And it appears to be different because having experimented various models, I think the debate has unequivocally been settled in favor of the fact that the economic model that we have been moving towards post-1991 certainly has paid very large dividends to India. But then, how do we tackle the problem of poverty? How do we still get millions who live in unacceptable conditions out of that? And therefore, our entire emphasis on reforms, on market reforms, on allowing entrepreneurship to grow, really has to be accompanied by some social consciousness of the economic planners. And that is why we've evolved this model where you allow India to grow, you allow entrepreneurship, you allow private sector to play a very important role, you get the government in to supplement where private sectors are not available, and you utilize these increased resources of the government, of the state, towards a better infrastructure, better townships, better healthcare facilities, better educational opportunities, and you put a large part of it as a resource in order to service the poor. They could be urban poor or they could be those living in rural areas. And the last few years that we've had these programs go on at a fairly rapid speed, we can see the effect of the change. And the change itself has been instrumental in raising the level of popular aspirations. So the aspirations are growing, people are becoming more impatient, they want things to happen faster. And therefore, if we look at the various verticals in which the Niti Aayog's proposal for a strategy for New India, it really encompasses all areas. How do you grow in areas of science, technology, education, healthcare, social sectors? How do you eradicate poverty? How do you concentrate on better infrastructure, better smart cities, and so on? And it's a fairly comprehensive agenda that they've laid down. And I have no doubt in my mind that we still have a long way to grow. The course that we have adopted is now gradually perfecting itself as the Indian model, in which you grow faster, you utilize the resource of the state in order to pull out millions of people out of poverty, give them a better quality of life, and improve the quality of infrastructure and other townships and smart cities, so that you create an environment in which the positive circle of India growing faster itself gets aided. Each decision is really aimed in this direction. I think when you think in terms of sound policy, the obvious debate whether sound policy pays more or slogans pay more. In democracies, these debates always will arise. Slogans have a transient life. They get found out. If they are not implemented, it doesn't take a decade or a generation to realize that they've been not implemented. The aspirational people, the people with a high level of aspiration and a very low level of patience now, will point out on day two or day three about the inability to convert slogans into reality. But sound policy will always put economy on a track in which it will perpetually get people out of poverty and give them a better quality of life. I think I've had an opportunity to glance through this entire document. An advance copy was sent to me earlier. And I have no doubt in my mind that this agenda that they have put into the public domain is a great agenda for debate. It would be extremely fruitful, not only for us in the government, but also for state governments and others, to have a serious look at it, because every brick in it, whether by the state or by a local body or by the central government or by other private businesses and others, would really have to be added up in order to add the entire energy of the system, in order to see that we become a much better country, keeping in mind the fact historically we have squandered several opportunities. Fortunately, we are at a cusp of making history, where in the last at least few decades, India has started making the full utilization of those opportunities. And that seems to be the course to go ahead. I am extremely grateful to Dr. Rajiv Kumar and his colleagues for having invited me. And I wish to compliment them for having prepared a very serious and a well thought out document, which at least will constitute a discussion on the future national agenda for India.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.